Good morning. My name is Siddharth Bedi from the Chitkara School of Hospitality, and today we're going to be talking about wines. First, we'll be discussing about the definition of wines, its history, classification of wines, wine laws, and the wine producing countries in the world. If you talk about the definition of wine, wine is an alcoholic drink made from the fermented grape juice. Yeast consumes the sugar in the grapes and converts it into ethanol, carbon dioxide, and heat. Different varieties of grapes and strains of yeast are used to produce various different styles of wines, and they are made at various parts of the world. If we talk about the basic history, wine has been a part of human society since generations, or we could say even for a very, very long period of time. The earliest traces that we go back to are somewhere around in 5000 BC or 4000 BC in Persia and Sicily, and moving forward we had traces from China in 7000 BC, Georgia in 6000 BC, Iran in 5000 BC, and Sicily in 4000 BC. Wine reached the Balkan countries in 4500 BC and was consumed and used in celebrations in ancient Greece, Thrace, and Rome. One of the earliest known wineries is dated to 4100 BC is the Arni 1 winery in Armenia. So wine has been a part of human society since a very long period of time. Now to talk about the classification of wines. Wines can be classified on the basis of their color. First, which then you have the white wines, we have red wines, rosé wines, and blush wines. Then on the basis of their taste, they have dry wines, which have no sugar content. Sweet wines, which have very less sugar, and medium wines, which have a little higher or medium sugar content. Then moving forward on the basis of content, still wines or table wines like your red wine and white wine. Then sparkling wines, which are made with the method of carbonization or method champenoise, and as well in which the second fermentation takes place inside the bottle. Third, we have fortified wines in this category, in which brandy is added before or after fermentation in order to increase the alcoholic strength. And fourth, we have aromatized wines like vermouths and bitters, which are used as digestives. And the last one that we have in this category is tonic wine, which is made in the United Kingdom and has been gaining popularity in Ireland and United Kingdom. Then basic classification is as follows. Wine can be classified as table wines, medicinal wines, natural wines, fortified wines, and fruit wines. Table wines can be further classified into still wine and sparkling wines. Still wines are your red wines, white wine, and cedar. Cedar is made with apples. Red wines can be further classified into dry red wine and sweet red wine. Same goes with white wine as well. It can be classified into dry white wine and sweet red wine. Sparkling wines are made with either the traditional method or the transfer method or the cuvée close method or rigid sparkling wines. Carbon dioxide plays a major role, and the method is called as carbonization, and even the concept of effervescence is used in this particular regard. Then we have your fortified wines, which have your sherry, which can be further classified into Oloroso, Amontillado, and Finot. In aromatized wines, we have vermouth, which is dry and sweet, and port wines, Madeira and Marsala, which are made in various parts of Europe and are very famous in those particular countries. In terms of fruit wines, we have based on peach, apple, citrus fruits, mint, plum, and pear. Then if you talk about the basic wine laws, wine laws are your legislations regulating the various aspects of production and sales of wines. The purpose of these wine laws includes combating wine frauds about origin, labeling, and classification. They are very particular about these particular things, as well as the regulated allowed additives and procedures in winemaking and viticulture. The legal drinking age in a particular country is not considered under wine laws. Basically, wine laws regulate the whole production of the wine, the additions that have to be made into the wine, its origin, the labeling, classification, and the procedure by which the wine is made in a particular region and country. Wine laws moving forward are regulated by regional, state, and local laws. The laws and the relative rigidity differ from New World and Old World wines. New World wines are those where the wine production has started taking place in the last 50 or 100 years, whereas Old World wines are those which are being prevalent and are being made in that particular country for more than 400-500 years. So they are, you know, very old into this business of winemaking. Old World wines tend to have more stringent regulations than New World wines. So obviously the people who are using the older methods would be more strict in terms of their overall procedures and their laws as compared to the people who are making new wines. Then wine laws moving forward. Some countries have appellation based regulations that cover boundaries as well as permitted grape varieties and winemaking practices such as France, Italy, Spain and Portugal. New worldwide countries such as United States, Australia pertain to boundary specifics and guaranteeing that a certain percentage of the grape comes from that area listed on the wine label. So the older countries, though, like France, Italy, Spain and Portugal, they are very much based on the appellation based regulations and they cover all the boundaries and the permitted grape varieties which are used in that particular area, whereas the new countries like United States and Australia do not focus on this particular thing. Their only concern is that the percentage mentioned on the bottle should be accurate and the area in which the wine is listed on the wine label should be the same always. Then wine producing countries, they can be divided into two basic parts. You can see the map here which shows various wine producing countries which are producing wines for a long period of time, whereas it also shows new countries which have just started this particular process of wine making. If we go about the old world wines, then we have France, Italy, Germany, Spain, Portugal and parts of Africa and Middle East, which are the countries where this particular trend has been into existence of wine making and wine drinking since various generations and millenniums, whereas we have the new world wines which are your countries which are USA, Australia, South Africa, Hungary, Switzerland, Argentina, Chile, Brazil and India. Our own country also falls in this particular category of New World wines, where the wine production has started in the last 50 odd years or maximum 100 years, whereas the Old World wine countries, they are more rigid in terms of their production methods and their laws, and the wine production has been prevalent for a very, very long period of time. Then, in case you have any questions, you can always put up your questions in the chat box. Don't forget to like, subscribe my videos. In the forthcoming video, we'll be talking about French wines, the laws that are there, and the various grapes and regions which are used in that particular region. Thank you.